All right. Hi, everyone. I'm looking on two screens here, so hopefully it's not too confusing to see both faces. I'm going to be sharing on my iPad here. I'm going to be teaching some fun digital tricks to use with Instagram and just some wonderful apps that we have on our phones these days, just to make your photographs look super professional and also to make really professional looking posts. So quickly, my name is Zoe Tessier. I am an instructor at the Art Students League. I teach photography, drawing and painting, and then I'm also, I help teach the teen camps over the summer. So I'm really happy to be here with you today. And I hope you enjoy this lesson. So I'm just gonna share my screen. I'm actually gonna switch hosts here on my iPad so I can share my screen with you. All right, so you're going to see my iPad screen. And the first thing that I actually just want to jump in and share with you is just a quick clip. So I'm going to jump into my Instagram. And you're going to see a couple friends of mine. I'm actually just going to look up an artist profile that shows an iMovie, and then I'm going to walk you through the process of how to make an iMovie and make it look really professional, and then how to add music with it. So I'm just going to type in here Kelsey Shields Art. And actually, is in my chats here. Lots of conversations. I just want to find the correct Kelsey. So this is the, or excuse me, it's Kaylee. So here is her Instagram. And I just love her work. She kind of reminds me of being an illustrator, and but she's a painter, and I saw one of these iMovie posts that she did, and I just thought it would be really helpful for the artists out there to know how to make something like this. So I will just let you enjoy this. Is music with this, but something with our recording is not doing it, so I apologize. So as you can see, she's clipped together a bunch of different painting techniques of hers, kind of blending progress shots, and then the whole piece all together. So it kind of zooms in and out with the iMovie app. And I also love this, like I love mixing paint. And people love to see the progress of painting, so, and any of your media. So this is a really, really awesome app that we can download for free. and put our images all together. So this is looping around, so I will stop this one. And I'm gonna hop out of here. Actually, just gonna make sure. Okay, good. You can hear me on here. All right, so what we're gonna do next is we're looking for this little purple. It's right next to actually my Instagram, right on the bottom of my screen. We are gonna download iMovie. So if you go to your app store, and you type in iMovie, it's gonna ask you a bunch of different questions, what sort of app you're using it for. I just typed in iMovie, and it's gonna be this one on the top right. So you can hit get, it is a free app, and I'm just gonna hit open. So I have mine down here. Oh, I guess I have to continue. Okay, so before we jump in to create any sort of project, what we want to do is we actually just want to work on all of our pictures, our videos, and everything first before we add it in here, because it's really challenging. You actually can't really crop the image in here once it's in. So let's go ahead and just jump into our pictures. We'll come back to that iMovie. So go ahead and go under your camera, and you are gonna click, oops, I didn't mean to hit a picture. Okay, I'm gonna toss that one. So I'm gonna go to all my photos, and it's really just about, you know, what kind of story you're telling. So if you're just kind of playing around, testing this for the first time, that's great. I'm going to actually make a movie on the most recent painting that I just finished. I am standing next to her, all the photos on the bottom. So if I just want to crop something out, you're just going to click on the picture. And you'll just hit edit. And you can go ahead and crop things by hitting that little box over here to the left, and you can just crop things down. So I'm sure a lot of you are used to this crop tool. It is awesome that it's so fast and easy to use. Okay, so you can crop your images. And I might want to think about what makes a cool video for you. So sometimes not seeing the entire thing all at once is the most fun, best way of kind of getting a taste of what you're really building the plot towards. So I might just do a snippet of the woman's face first, and then go on from there and add my pictures all together. So I'll hit done. You can also play with different filters on here, so really make all the images look good. So I'm gonna go to my filter, which is over on the left-hand side. You can actually see the little things that are changing on the left-hand side on my iPad. So I'm gonna go to that middle one where all the circles are overlapping, and you can change your filter just like this. So just go to ones that you like. And when you find the one that you like, go ahead and hit done. Okay. So now what I'm gonna do, so do that to all of your photos, do it to your videos if they're really long. You'll kind of see how iMovie works with super long videos. It might not squeeze in the whole thing. So just kind of plan ahead, do all of your basic edits before you bring it into iMovie. So I'm gonna go back to this iMovie, and I'm gonna go ahead and create a project. and I'm just going to make a really basic movie. So in here, you can go ahead and just select any ones that you want. So I'm scrolling down because I have a bunch of different videos of kind of this painting in progress. So this is actually the first one that I did over on the left. So I'm just going to tap it. I'm going to select it. And I'm just going to go through and select all the pictures I want for the clip. So I'm going to have to really kind of jump around. So here's another progress shot. Here's another video. Then maybe just a piece of her face. And then the whole face. And then me smiling with it. And then the entire one. Okay. So you can click as many as you'd like. And then at the bottom, on the bottom toolbar, you're going to hit Create Movie. So it's kind of compiling them all into your movie. So I'm actually going backwards. I'm going to play it from the start. And so if I actually want to see more of the top of where I am, I'm going to just click on wherever that is in here. You can play with speed, so maybe you want it to go a little bit faster, kind of a hyperlapse. You can play with different actions. You can play with filters in here, everything down at the bottom. You can also crop it in so it starts a little bit faster. So if that video is just going really long, you are done with kind of seeing your own self paint and it's just taking too long, go ahead and just crop it by just squeezing the videos together. So it just kind of moves in to your photos really nice, and then it will come back out. And I'm going to stop it right there, and I'm just going to compile this one. So it's just going to play all of these. On the bottom, you can play with different things. You can dissolve it. You can make it more of a slideshow. You can wipe and you can fade it. So there's so many fun things that you can do with your actual video. And then kind of the end piece. So again, we can shrink the amount of time that they're shown by just squeezing our fingers together. So this one in here might be just a little too long. Great, play. You have an option to do a little recording in the top left, so you have a little microphone that you could talk in on your pieces and describe it. So once you're done and you feel comfortable with it, go ahead and click done. And you can always go back and edit it if you want. Up here on the top, there's a little settings dial. And you can even add more filters to your entire video that way if you wish. You can also add music to the piece. So I apologize right now. I can't play music on here with my Zoom call on my computer and my iPad because I think it will echo really bad. It just is not even playing. So you're going to click on different. These are all songs over here. So it's kind of a theme. And then you can also click theme soundtrack if you want. Let's actually see if that works. Yeah, it's not working on my iPad. So that's just a way to add really amazing music. And then you can also choose different fading options if you wish. So hopefully that was kind of a fun little tutorial with that one. Go ahead and click done. And then when you're done with your movie, at the very bottom, you can always play with trailers on this app too. I'm just going to show you how to do a movie with it today. You can always add it by doing the little bottom square with the arrow. That's your share button. And you can share it right onto Instagram like this. It will take a minute or two to maybe upload and export your movie. And then you can hit share. One quick tip with this also is if you see a little black screen, so you can write in your caption kind of up here on the top. If you see a little black screen that starts off that way and you want it to look like something, so it's not a black screen when you share it, you can hit cancel and we'll edit it again. And that just means you have to change it from this fade in from black. So you'll actually have a picture. So if you don't want your iMovie to show up on Instagram as being a black video, you just have to change this from fade in from black or fade out from black. Just change them both so it doesn't look like that. So I'm gonna hit done. And let's see what it looks like this time. So as you can see now in your share button, instead of it being a black screen, it actually shows something that you're doing in that screen. So hopefully that makes sense. This app is super friendly to use and hopefully you have a lot of fun with it. All right, so we talked about cropping basic pictures in our iPad or on your phone. It's the same. I'm on an Apple iPad. So I'm just going to go actually through the filters again on our camera. So if you go to your camera and you want to change anything of your pictures, photo here, I'll just go up to edit and we can just look at those little three circles that overlap on the left-hand side in our toolbar. And we can look at all of our different filters. Now, I know everyone probably knows where their filters are. I don't mean to repeat or give you any information that you've already known in the past. I'm just bringing up filters right now because if you're trying to bring a really professional look to your Instagram account, you're going to want to stick with the same sort of filter. So I'm actually going to just show you a couple different themes that stick with the same sort of filter and make their Instagram look really, really professional. So I'm first going to pull up I have to keep this. So I'm going to actually look at a food photography. Excuse me, this is Two Loves Studio. And if you're into food photography, this is great. This is perfect for you. But if you're not, from what you can take from this is just the filters. So go ahead and just check this out. You can also search in Instagram filter posts and look and see the style of the different filters that is continuous throughout the entire portfolio of the artist's work. So as you can see in this one, it kind of has this darker tint to it. Not all the pictures are really, really bright and in your face. They're a little bit dimmed out and kind of have this moody, almost dramatic feeling to it. So it looks really professional because this artist has used a really consistent filter in all of their posts. So again, this one is called To Love Studio. If you want to go back and revisit this sort of theme. So the next one I'm going to show you is called Stella. And I have these written down just so I don't forget. So here's another artist. She seems very artistic in her work and her posts that she does. She's sticking with a common filter in her photographs and also a common color scheme. So my Instagram is really bright and loud. It's just a lot of my artwork and kind of my expression. So kind of try and figure out the style when you post your work. If you're a little bit more muted, maybe you use kind of these natural pink tones that you love and be really consistent in your posts, kind of like this artist. Or if you're not into that, you can stick with your same bright, colorful posts as you've been doing and kind of be all over the place if that's your style. So again, just really nice, same sort of filter that she's using, same sort of color scheme. And if you squint your eyes with the actual portfolio, you're going to see kind of an interesting patterns of highlights and darks. And that's what keeps the viewer eye keep moving and also kind of rested in Instagram posts. So it's an art within an art. All right. I'm going to pull up two more. This next one. So this guy goes by Mr. Pink, as you can probably tell. We know why. Some of the pictures look like they have a filter on them, but more than anything, he's just having a common color scheme throughout the entire piece. So no matter if you're doing all photography or you're shooting artwork and posting it on here, try and pay attention to if you're going with the same filter or the same color scheme. And a lot of people actually recognize something like that and associate your work with your color or your style. If you get that. I don't know if people get that about your work, but people know about my work. It's super bright and colorful. It's a little bit flat. So same with you. You might be posting and kind of have a style. So Mr. Pink, that's what he's known for, and we can see why. All right. So the last one here I'm going to share with you is Dylan First. So huge landscape photographer, perfect for this photography month with the Art Students League. I'm just looking at my notes here. So I'm going to jump in. Common filter here, very common theme with his color scheme. But he also uses a little bit of hyperlapse in his movies or his clips. So I'm going to jump into hyperlapse in just a second here. But I just kind of want to jump in and show you what it really looks like. Let's try this one. So it's kind of that hyperlapse that you see moving with the sky and the clouds. Sometimes clouds move that fast. Let's try another one in here. So here we have a lot of hyperlapse, right? A lot of movement in the water. If you're looking at artist work and you're like, I would love to know how to do something like that, I'm gonna jump in here and just show you. So that guy's account is named Firsty. So you should have it in your camera app. And it's gonna be called that time lapse. So sorry, my screen is looking up with my iPad. And now it's my face. So I'm gonna flip this. And I'm just gonna do a quick clip for you. So sorry, I'm just sitting in my office right now, so it's not that pretty of a space. But I'm just gonna go ahead and do a quick filming. And click the red button on the right again. And then you can click and watch and play it. So it's really, really fast. So that's one hyperlapse. So it's just kind of giving you one option with this hyperlapse and speed. Sometimes you might have another option to change the speed of your hyperlapse, but the one thing that you can do on here that I'll demo with my iPad is you can cut it down by just moving in the little arrows. It should let you move it in. So it should let you edit it. I don't know why mine is. So if you pull in these little white arrows, you should be able to edit it. I know I can do it on my phone, and my iPad's being a little quirky right now. So I'm gonna jump out of that one. And I'm gonna show you, there should be another app for your phone or your iPad if you choose to do that. I actually have it on my phone. And it is called Hyperlapse. And with this Hyperlapse, if you record it on your phone or your iPad, you can choose what speed you want it to be at. And I will just show you right on here what it is called. Hyperlapse, and it's actually Instagram that creates it. All right. It's now wanting to just swipe to continue. Okay. Great. Okay. All right. So if I open this one up and I do my hyperlapse on here, okay, hitting some difficulties with the iPad with hyperlapse. It's just another free program that you can use to make that really fast speed video that you'd normally see on one of those Instagram posts. So that's all they're using. So either you can use it on your camera in your hyperlapse, or you can use the free app. So I just wanted to show you one more piece here from an Instagram artist that does panorama pictures. And then I'll also show you how to find the panorama setting in your phone or in your iPad. So, it is. There he is. So another really, really amazing landscape photographer here. I'm just going to click on this first piece of his. It's in Italy. It's this beautiful panorama photograph. And so anytime you kind of see these things kind of squishing into that canvas or that picture plane, it's mostly just one of those settings in our phones that we can all do. That's the panorama setting. So how we find it on our camera is I'm just going to scroll over on the left again, and I'm just going to go to pano. So if you hold your screen up, again, my office here. So I'm just going to hold my hands really steady. I'm going to click the shutter on the right. So hold, you're just going to hold it down and then you'll lift up. Slow down. And then you get kind of this pano shot. All right. So again, my little office down here, there's not a whole lot going on, but this would be versus if I were to just take a photo, flip that, right? So regular photo versus our pano photo. So just another really fun app that you can use in your camera, on your iPod, and make it look just really, really professional and clean. So hopefully all those tips were really fun for you to watch and see. One last little quick tip that I will do here. I'm gonna jump back into iPad, into my Instagram, and you might see some people, here is my Instagram. So as you can see, there's not a whole lot of consistency with my filter or my colors. That's not what I'm going for. I'm going for just posting my art, but I have done a couple of the videos. So as you can see in this middle one, there is music to it. It's just a quick clip. So I'm doing just a couple, you know, quick things of just detail in here of one of my paintings. And then it zooms into another screen. So that is iMovie, what I originally showed you. A couple of these have filters on them. But one last thing I wanted to show you, if you use this little blue plus sign up here on the top by your face, I have to enable this. So let's say I want to make some sort of post with music. Okay. So I'm going to go ahead, I'm going to select multiple. So up on the top right, if you just click select multiple, you can collect a bunch and make a story. Right? So just click a bunch, whatever you're trying to tell. I'm going to hit next. You can squeeze and shrink your picture down, or you can open it up by just enlarging with your fingers. So I'm squeezing, or I'm pulling my fingers apart to enlarge it. So that's kind of fun. You can use filters by just swiping your finger on top of the photo. So I'm just swiping gently and lightly to get all of those different filters right on our pictures. Once you're ready to go to the next one and edit the next one, don't hit next. Just click on the right-hand side on the picture. And you can also move it around with your fingers, just a really fun app to use. And then swipe to get that filter that you like. So just keep hitting right to go to the next picture and change it. To add music to this, I know some people love to add music. You click the little face and you will see music down here. So you can choose any of these fun beats that you wish. When you're done with that, you can actually go to different parts of the song. You can hit done. You can add text. There's a ton of different fun things that you can do on here. And then you'll hit next, and then you'll go ahead and hit share so it shares to your story. Okay? So I'm not gonna share that. I'm just gonna exit it out and discard it. All right. So I'm just gonna stop there. I hope everyone enjoyed watching. I hope this was a really fun lesson for you. Have fun, enjoy posting, enjoy doing artwork, always, always. And it was an absolute pleasure teaching you a lesson. So I'm just gonna hop out of here. Thank you again.